back again with a look into our vault. Today we're headed back to July 15th, 2019, as we catch the first train over Raton Pass to be powered exclusively by Siemens Charger locomotives. These locomotives are diesel electrics powered by a Cummins 16-cylinder diesel power plant. Based on the Vectron locomotives built by Siemens for the European market, these American-built chargers are the new face of the American passenger rail scene. The SC-44s seen here were taken from the Illinois pool of locomotives and were brought out west for testing on the Southwest Chief Route. To accomplish real-world testing, they were put on a non-revenue train consisting of a heritage sleeper, three viewliners, an Amfleet cafe, and three viewliner baggage cars. In the lead, though, were two General Electric P-42 Genesis-type locomotives, but were isolated to allow the chargers to provide all the propulsion, head-end power, and dynamic braking. With these locomotives isolated and the trailing cars, they also helped create enough unpowered weight to simulate a fully loaded Southwest Chief over America's steepest Class 1 mainline trackage. The distinctive chug of the P-42s is noticeably absent as the chargers attack the grade here at the ghost town of Morley, an old company town of the Colorado Fuel and Iron Company. Near the summit of Raton, the test train wraps around the Wooten Curve between Interstate 25 and the Dick Wooten Ranch. Once over the apex of the grade that is just west of the Raton tunnels, the chargers safely and easily guide the train down the grade, their extended range dynamics making the normal set of air brakes unnecessary, as their dynamic brakes are much more powerful than the old Genesis locomotives. We meet up with the train once again at Kyoto Siding, a long out-of-service meeting point. Free of the bottleneck of the pass, the train rockets across the grasslands of Hebron as the Raton Ridge looms far behind. Leapfrogging ahead, we catch a train at Colmore after maintenance away crews clear the tracks. This siding, named because of its location on the Colfax-Mora County line, is one of the first locations where semaphores once cast shadows on the rails here. This set on the west end was removed only a few months after this move. Approaching wagon mound, the train creeps towards wagon mound and splits the pair of semaphores at milepost 724. Note the bent blade of the signal, which was damaged by high winds and the bomb cyclone that hit earlier that winter. Creeping through wagon mound, we'll leave the test train here. Pretty soon, the new variation of the chargers, the Amtrak Long Distance Charger 4200 horsepower, better known as the ALC-42, will soon be hitting the rails on this fabled piece of Santa Fe railway trackage.
Hey guys, big deal here. If you're seeing this, you've reached the end of the video. So if you haven't already, make sure to click like, subscribe, hit that bell, all that stuff.